Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for being here today at this very exciting announcement. My name is Janice Morley-Leconte. I am the MLA for Seine River, and I am pleased to be here today with some of my colleagues from the legislature. Sarah Guillemard, the Honourable Minister of Health, Mental Health and Community Wellness, and Mr. Wayne Ewasko, the Honourable Minister of Education and Early Childhood Learning. Also attending today's announcement is Ms. Wendy Bloomfield, the chairperson of the Child Nutrition Council of Manitoba and the chairperson for Seine River School Division, Troy Calder, principal of Acadia Junior High, Robert Worley, vice principal of Acadia, Patricia Pawluk, home economics teacher at Acadia, Lisa Bowles, superintendent of education and CEO of the Pembina Trail School Division, Cindy Noctegal, trustee for Ward 3 of Pembina Trails, and Colleen Roberts, assistant superintendent, curriculum and learning, and principal of General Byng School. Thank you all for joining us today. We acknowledge that we are gathered on Treaty 1 territory and that Manitoba is located on the homeland of the Red River Métis. At this moment, I would like to invite Minister Guillemard to the podium.
Thank you very much for that introduction, Janice, and for agreeing to MC today. Appreciate that. Good afternoon, everyone. I am Sarah Guillemard, the Minister of Mental Health and Community Wellness. I would like to offer a special welcome to my colleague, Wayne Ewasko, Minister of Education, as well as to Wendy Bloomfield from the Child Nutrition Council of Manitoba and Acadia's home economics teacher, Patricia Pawluk. I also want to take a moment to thank Acadia Junior High's principal, Troy Calder, for hosting us here today at Acadia Junior High, as well as for the leadership and board who have joined us from the school division, as well as some representatives from MTS today. Je tiens à profiter de l'occasion pour reconnaître que nous sommes sur le territoire du traité numéro 1 et sur les terres ancestrales des peuples Anishinaabeg, Cree, Oji-Cree, Dakota et Dene, et de la Nation Métis du Rivière Rouge. Nous reconnaissons que le nord du Manitoba comprend des terres qui étaient et sont les terres ancestrales des Inuits. Before I share details about today's announcement, I would like to also acknowledge that I am speaking to you from Treaty 1 territory, the traditional territory of the Anishinaabeg, Cree, Oji-Cree, Dakota, and Dene people, and on the homeland of the Red River, Métis. We acknowledge northern Manitoba includes lands that were and are the ancestral lands of the Inuit. As we all know, many families have struggled to access healthy and affordable food throughout the COVID-19 pandemic. As children and their families prepare for the start of another busy school year, it is vital that Manitoba children have reliable access to nourishing foods, not only for the academic performances, but for optimal development and overall well-being. It gives me great pleasure to announce that our government is providing an increase of $1.3 million in funding to the Child Nutrition Council of Manitoba in order to strengthen the support of the school meal and snack programs across the province. This new funding will bring the total provincial funding for CNCM to $2.5 million. The Child Nutrition Council of Manitoba provides application-based nourishment grant funding to schools across Manitoba in support of breakfast, lunch, and snack programs. School nourishment programs provide a social environment where students can eat nutritious meals together and begin the school day well-fed. The increased funding will enable CNCM to grow the number of school-based meal and snack programs they support throughout the province and reach many more students each school day. Together with our community partners, our government is committed to ensuring that Manitoba children have the resources and programming they need to learn, grow, and to succeed. I wish the school staff and the students the best as you begin a new school year. Thank you. Merci. Miigwech. I'm going to steal your notes.
Thank you, Minister. I would like now to invite Minister Ewasko to say a few words.
Thank you, and good afternoon, and and welcome to sunny South Winnipeg, and thank you very much to Acadia School for hosting us, and Ms. Pawluk for allowing us into your domain that you're going to be spending the next 10 plus months in here, absolutely teaching our kids some very, very, very important life skills that they're going to take with them into the future. I want to thank Minister Guillemard and, of course, my good friend and colleague, MLA Janice Morley-Lecomp, for emceeing this afternoon's event. I think this is absolutely incredible, and I'm so glad to see so many people participating and here with us this afternoon. As the Minister of Education and Early Childhood Learning, on behalf of our Premier Heather Stephenson, and my colleagues at the Manitoba Legislature, it is so great to be here to share this very important announcement this afternoon. Children may come to school hungry for a variety of reasons. It can include limited access to food in the home, or long bus rides to school, hectic mornings, or early drop-offs. Research has shown that hunger and poor nutrition are linked to challenges with school achievement, and in some instances, increased absenteeism. La recherche montre que la femme est liée au défi à la réussite scolaire et aussi à l'absentéisme. But the research also tells us that children who regularly eat a nutritious breakfast arrive at school more prepared for learning compared to the children who do not. We also know access to nutritious food at school any time of the day is beneficial. School nutrition programs ensure that every child has the opportunity to start the school day off in a good way. Students who participate in school meal programs eat more fruits and vegetables and drink more milk than their peers and water. These programs also have a positive impact on academic achievement and, again, attendance. Eating a healthy breakfast also has positive impacts on a child's overall development. Manitoba schools have recognized the benefits of nutrition programs on individual students, but also on the school and broader community. When students are provided healthy food, embrace eating well, and are performing better in the classroom, it will lead to a healthier community and overall a healthier province. Together with mental health and community wellness, Manitoba is taking a whole of government approach to creating healthy school environments which promote physical and mental well-being. I would like to congratulate Child Nutrition Council of Manitoba on receiving this funding increase and commend them for the positive work they're doing in schools to address food insecurity and create a healthy eating environment. This additional investment was identified as a priority in the report of the Commission on K-12 Education and aligns with the Manitoba K-12 Education Action Plan, which identified actions to remove barriers to participation and engage in learning. Delivering on this priority with the Council benefits not only children's health, but also correlates with better school outcomes and improves every part of their lives. Thank you for joining us this afternoon, and merci, and enjoy the sunshine.
Thank you, Ms. Minister Ewasko. I would now like to ask Ms. Wendy Bloomfield to come to the podium.
It's all good.
Yeah, I think it's okay the way it was. Okay. Well, I'm extremely pleased to be here this afternoon representing the Child Nutrition Council of Manitoba. We are so thankful both for the ongoing commitment the provincial government has made over the past number of years and for this additional funding announcement of $1.3 million for the upcoming school year. We hear time and again from our school leaders and parents how valuable school nutrition and meal programs are in Manitoba and how important they are to the continuing learning of students on a day-to-day basis. Over the past number of years, we have seen a steady rise in the numbers of schools as well as the number of students accessing school meal programs. And now, with food costs rising day by day, this new funding from the provincial government will allow Child Nutrition Council of Manitoba to increase our funding support to schools from just under 10% to almost 20% of calculated food costs. I would like to thank both the dedicated staff and board of the Child Nutrition Council of Manitoba for being such strong advocates for the students of Manitoba and the provincial government to listening to our plea. The Child Nutrition Council of Manitoba is committed to working in collaboration with the provincial government to ensure that funding for school meal and snack programs is both adequate and sustainable. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Bloomfield, for those few lovely words. Now I would like to call upon Ms. Pawluk to say a few words.
Good afternoon. I'd like to start this afternoon by saying thank you for the additional funding. The grant we received last year at Acadia helped provide nutritious breakfast, snack, and lunches for students who do not have adequate food at home or miss meals for various reasons beyond their control. The funding also allowed us to occasionally provide some of our Acadia families with basic food hampers that consisted of meal staples. The additional funding will allow us to address the rising cost of groceries and expand our breakfast and lunch programs to provide more substantial meals, including hot dishes, over the winter. As you can well imagine, a student who has limited access to food at home may be so distracted they're unable to learn, or they may not attend school at all. It is well documented that a student's developing brain and body require sufficient fuel to develop and grow, and so by supplying additional resources, our students are in a better position to learn and achieve success. To reiterate, the increase in funding will allow schools in general, and including Acadia, to increase an increased opportunity to better meet the needs, the nutritional needs of all of our students. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Pawluk. That concludes the formal portion of our interview or session today. If there are any questions, you are now able to ask them. Thank you.